Breaking news. Fulani herdsmen evacuation begins. The leader of the Fulani herdsmen and secretary of Meti Ala Cattle Breeders Association of Nigeria, Mark Bang, in Kano State, Zubaru Ibrahim, has disclosed that herdsmen from southwest, southeast, and other parts of the country have indicated interest to relocate to the Kano Ruga settlements. According to Ibrahim, some of the herdsmen are from states such as Nasarawa State, Niger, Enugu, Oyo, among others. He said that herdsmen from five states of the Federation have already relocated to Kano State. We have some Fulani herdsmen from Kebbi, Zamfara, Kaduna, Sokoto, and Jigawa who are now in Kano State. Ibrahim was quoted by Vanguard. The governor has invited any willing to stay in the Ruga settlement to come. If they come and they are good people, nothing will stop us from receiving them. All they need to do is to follow the rules and regulations of government. They should go for grazing in the afternoon and not at night. Nothing can stop them from coming if they are interested, since the governor of Ondo State has gone to the media to say that the herdsmen should vacate the area. Instead of staying there, they should leave. They should leave so that something bad does not happen to them and their property. They should just vacate the area of their safety. Governor Abdullahi Ganduje of Kano State had recently declared that it was no longer acceptable for herdsmen to move their animals from the north to the south. Ganduje stated this while calling on the government to restrict the movement of herders and cattle from the north to other parts of Nigeria. Ganduje explained that this would end to the frequent clash between herdsmen and farmers in the country. Fulani herdsmen have been accused of causing mayhem in different parts of the country, leading to quit notices and ultimatums on them to vacate part of the southeast and also southwest. Governors of the southwest and southeast have recently announced ban on open grazing and movement of cattle by foot. Thank you, my viewers, for listening to this news. Wow. I think people should stop calling or praising Buhari because he has done nothing. Instead, he caused so many problems for this country. You can imagine. Called the cabal by their names. Buhari is either unwell. He's not capable of handling this country. He's not capable. A lot of Nigerian citizens, they respect him. Fine, I didn't say you should not respect him. But when you know that this, what Buhari is doing in this country is not something you praise him for, then you don't need to do that. Yes. It is tantamount to wickedness when he gangs in there when he knows that he is incapable of doing good for Nigeria. And he promised to stand by Nigerians. He promised to guide and protect them when he was coming in, when he was protesting as the president of this country. But now look at what is happening. Look at what is happening. Buhari should not be trusted. It should not be trusted at all. But if you trust Buhari, bet you definitely regret ever trusting him. Because when he starts betraying you, then you know that President Muhammadu Buhari is not someone that you should trust. Yes. That is it. So you should not trust him. I think Bradley needs advice. Did I say advice? He doesn't need any advice anymore, because we see a lot of governors, senators advising him on how to tackle the issues of this country, but all to no avail. He still kept on being adamant, leaving the citizens to die, leaving the citizens to collapse, leaving the citizens to be slaves. This is not fair. This is an height of wickedness, as far as I'm concerned. It's an height of wickedness. Imagine, to what Ganduje has just said, it's a welcoming development. They should stay where they belong. I mean, these X-Men. The Southern governor should emulate Akeredolu's policy. If they can emulate Akeredolu's policy, bet you, bet me, this country will be a better place. Yes, cows and men should not be allowed to roam about in the city. To what Ganduje just said. Truly, they should not be allowed to roam about. That is it. They should not be allowed to roam about in this area, in any community, because they are not people that we should trust. Buhari is the one giving them this chance. He's the one giving them this chance to do whatever they like. If not, we wouldn't have been hearing of X-Men and Boko Haram ever again in this country. If the president and those that are sponsoring X-Men and Boko Haram, if they don't repent of their sins, if they don't stop this act, then bet me, this country has not seen anything yet. More problems will be on this country. You start seeing different things. You start experiencing what the prophecy Adeboye gave to Nigerians. You start seeing that it will start manifesting. But I know that with God, all things are possible. 2023 is around the corner. Just only next year, then Buhari would leave the seat of presidency and there will be peace again radiating in this country. So viewers, you have heard it all from Ganduje and some governors of Southeast and Southwest. What is your take on this? Your comment concerning this news will be very much guided. If you can drop them below the comment box, click on the subscription button as well as the bell button to receive notifications whenever we upload any new videos. Thank you.